Join me inside Nolan Carroll's fridge. Former NFL star and current podcast, philanthropy, rum-owning, and entrepreneurial superstar. I'm Carole Mac, and this is What's in My Fridge.
I can't wait to see what's in that thing.
But first, let's learn more about Nolan Carroll.
My most proud moment, it would have to be my son coming to my practice. To have him put on the helmet and just watch me practice, that was by far the most proud moment I could have as a football player.
And so now you've started a new life. This podcast is on fire.
My podcast is really focusing on people that I've interacted with throughout my football career, and even before that. Those are the people that made me who I am today.
So tell me how you're serving, obviously through your podcast, but also children. I've got to hear about this.
Oh yeah, the Nolan Carroll Foundation. It's geared towards underprivileged youth, and it's mainly more about STEM education. But what I do is I sponsor a couple schools and I provide them STEM modules, whether it's marshmallows, markers, volcanoes, it could be a STEM kit with lollipop sticks. And what you get them to do is to think on how to create something out of nothing.
Let's talk food, my favorite subject. All right, we know you're a former football player. How did food inform playing on the field?
It was something that was the engine that drove our bodies. The more I was getting my body beat up, I needed to recover just as fast. So I needed to find something that I was gonna put in my body to help me do that. I was lucky enough to have Chip Kelly explain how different foods work when you sleep, how different foods work when you wanna recover.
So was there one thing you had in your diet that made the most impact?
Any type of greens. I broke my leg a couple times. I had a lot of pockets of holes in my bones. Someone says because you have a low amount of iron, you have a low amount of zinc. And when I learned that, I started making an emphasis to eat some type of greens daily so it could help me recover when I was playing.
Okay, I'm super excited about this. So he owns a rum company, and the name is amazing. Let's talk about some YOLO.
I'm Caribbean, both my parents are Caribbean, so rum is, it's a part of our culture. The brand says it alone, you only live once.
We're gonna do a little rapid fire. How does that sound?
Ooh, let's go.
Okay, it's a food rapid fire, and it's about your favorites. Breakfast, lunch, or dinner?
Breakfast.
Ooh, you're faster than I am. Cook or eat?
Cook.
Woo! You're so fast.
Yeah.
Favorite go-to meal?
Oh man, steak and asparagus.
Ooh, splurge.
Splurge. Steak and shake?
Oh, that's a cheap eat. That's what I was gonna ask next. Okay, favorite restaurant of all time?
Wow, Capital Grille.
Okay, favorite wine?
Red wine, Merlot.
Ooh.
Preferably from Chile.
Oh, you know your wines. We're gonna have some conversations.
A little bit.
So can you tell us your favorite cocktail made with this guy?
Ooh, it's the old fashioned.
Okay, speaking of the best day ever, I need to see your fridge.
Oh, why not?
Right?
That's what I was waiting for.
Yes! Okay, take me into your fridge.
Okay.
Whoa! Okay, clean, beautiful, hot. Okay, first of all, I need to hear about these guys. Soul Kick.
So in the mornings when I wake up, the best thing I like to do is to have some type of juice. It's more about memory, because I had a lot of concussions when I was playing football. Turmeric, ginger, all these things help your body, help your mind, kickstart in the morning.
Yes! Okay, this is my favorite.
Yeah.
What in the world are we talking about here? They're candy corns.
Halloween is upon us, people.
Okay, wait.
It's the season.
Sure.
There we go.
Cheers.
There we go.
I want to say this is addictive. You have this in your fridge right now. How
keep
do
it
you
cool.
eat it?
You see, I mean, I ate it before we got home.
No, you did.
I'm still eating it.
Okay, I'm kind of in love with that. All right, and meat, we have your favorite meat up here. I love it.
Oh, yeah. Josh is down here in Miami.
What?
He's actually...
This marbling on this. Stop.
He's good at what he does.
What kind is this? What kind of beef is this?
Australian Wagyu.
I thought it was Wagyu.
All Wagyu. But he sells them in individual packs, which helps me out because I'm not spending $200-$300 on one in a restaurant when I can get it for $20 instead. A little frugal when it comes to that, but still good.
Still good.
Uh-huh.
And I see a donut.
Yeah.
Does that have bacon on top of that?
It does.
Ah!
You got good eyes. This is from my hometown, Jacksonville, Florida. There's a spot called Urban Bean. Every time I go home, I gotta get one.
And by far, this is the best thing in Nolan Carroll's fridge. Thank you for taking me through your fridge.
Oh, no problem. Thank you.
You are amazing.
I appreciate it.
And you know what? We gotta do that shot. Are we ready for this?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you. Oh my God, it's so good. It's so good.